Hey everyone, Scott Cunningham, aka Scottsy Business. Today we're going to be talking about Narrative and their token Nerve. So they've recently posted an announcement saying that they're going to be shutting down the platform on December 30th, which is convenient given that I just recently certified my account. So naturally, having to pay them $15 and give them my KYC information, naturally, just a week later, they are shutting down the entire platform. And here, I'll share my screen here. And of course, they say, oh, but we'll let you, you know, withdraw your funds and da-da-da. It's like, okay, great. They had a minimum withdrawal of 15,000 Nerve. And over my entire time on the platform, I'd only earned like 8,000. And you go to sell now, it's worth like a dollar. And who's even buying it? So, yeah, I mean, they don't really give us much of a good reason. They just say, unfortunately, market events, regulatory uncertainty, and limited resources has forced us to stop. How have they been forced to stop? They had a token sale originally that generated millions. From what I've been told, it was about 8 million, but giving them the most benefit of the doubt with the cheapest possible, you know, scenario, I calculated that they earned over 5 million. If you look at here, they sold 31,928,000 Nerve. And originally, a NEO token at the time would buy you 400 in the private sale. And then after the public sale, 333, then 315, then after that, 300. So I did this calculation just with the 300. So doing the most bottom of the line, cheapest possible, or I guess technically the most expensive possible. So if you did it with the 400, maybe it would be different. But regardless, millions and millions. Okay, to be fair, millions of dollars. And NEO at the time was worth, it was fluctuating between about $80 and $50. At the time, it was worth a lot. It's worth way less now. It's like $8 or $9. And they sold over 1,000 niches. So you can see niches here. To be fair, I don't know what they were charging originally. Obviously, it was much less or else it wouldn't have been plausible at all. Because had you have bought Nerve originally and then you bought a niche with today's value, if you originally bought when NEO was like $50 and you were only getting 400, this 695,000 Nerve just to get the Dodge Charger niche or bow hunting, this is about $80,000 US if you had bought in the ICO. And most people reported that they were losing money by owning niches. You were supposed to make money by being a niche owner and people posting in the niche. And this wasn't even like you own this. You had to renew it every year. So people were just losing so much money. So I can't imagine how much money they were making off of all this. Probably just insane amounts of money on top of their millions and millions from the ICO. This site is bare bones. How do they have limited resources, right? Like, how is that even possible? Well, it's not. This was a scam. They waited as long as they could and they exit scammed. It's as simple as that, right? Like, there's no plausible explanation as to how they somehow ran out of their millions of dollars and couldn't continue to keep this going. It's just not realistic. And the reason that I like to share this is because I previously talked about this and I said in my comprehensive review, see, here's the thing. The reason that I do my comprehensive reviews, I rigorously test these. I still use Narrative for such a long time, even though I didn't have a lot of faith in it, because I'm testing them for you guys so that you don't have to waste your money, your time, and so that you can get the most informed decision and the most information to make that decision for deciding where you're going to invest your money and time into what platforms, what is going to be successful. This is just another time where I've been historically correct in not recommending a platform. And I don't say this to brag. I say this because I would hope that I was correct with the amount of research and time spent doing the comprehensive reviews that I do. And again, Hyperspace went down. I said it wasn't viable either. There's hundreds that I've said have not been viable. And I'm curious to see which one goes down next. honestly, if I were to make a guess right now and maybe be historically correct again, and according to my comprehensive review, would back this up, it's either going to be Waku, Whale Shares, Tribe, and there's slight potential that it could be BitTube or Sapien, but those are way further along. Like that could be like 5 years if they don't like pick up their game. But I think they both have potential to improve and get better. Currently, though, Tribe, you can't even do transactions because of how bad the EOS CPU usage is. Waku and Whale Shares were scams. I'm surprised they've lasted as long as they've lasted. And, you know, it's just it's ridiculous that these even lasted as long as they did and got as much support as they did to begin with. So I'm actually curious, what platform is going down next? And I don't think this is like bad or scary for the blockchain space. I think it's natural that a bunch of things pop up, and at the end of the day, there's only going to be a handful that are going to survive, like we saw with regular traditional social media at the beginning. And I say like, and the things that I have recommended have been doing fairly well. So look at Mines, look at Library, look at Steam, PublishOX, Uptrend. Pretty much those are my main ones to recommend to you. Outside of that, it's kind of like, you know, there's potential. They could do okay. I'd also recommend checking out Gab and BitChute. Those are great alternative platforms, but they're not really blockchain or cryptocurrency monetized platforms, because that's what we're talking about here. We're talking about blockchain platforms or crypto monetized platforms. Then these are social platforms that we're talking about. But in my comprehensive review, I did previously say Narrative looks like it could have potential, but it's mainly geared to reward early adopters. For example, getting a niche originally was between $50 and $500. Okay, so that's not nearly as bad as what it is today. But regardless, I mean, it's a failure today. So I wasn't a huge fan of it originally. But again, I even saw that niche owners were upset because they were having to pay to renew their ownership and they were making nothing. So they were losing money and they were kind of penalizing you if you weren't certifying and paying them, which was also only possible through PayPal, not even cryptocurrency. So they were relying on central payment processors and it didn't have a ton of adoption. It didn't have a ton of use. It was in my not recommended section. Mind you, the reason I kept using it was because it was definitely in the upper percentile of the not recommended. There was many platforms that I didn't recommend that I still use today because I'm testing them to see if maybe in the next review that they got better. Because that's what I'm doing. I'm trying to test all of these platforms and give you the most informed decision. I don't just test it once and then throw it away. I make new reviews every like 3 to 6 months to give you the most updated and informed decision making and a comprehensive review, right? If you look at my last comprehensive review, it was over 10,000 words and it was like an hour long and I barely scratched the surface with that video. So I'm really curious to hear what you guys think is going to be the next platform to go down. Do not touch Narrative with a 10-foot pole. It's probably going to have a negative effect on Neo if it hasn't already. What do you think about Narrative? Was it just a total scam? Do you really think that they just couldn't support themselves with the millions of dollars they had? I don't know. To me, it really just seems like a scam. But, you know, regardless, I waste money and my time to do this for you guys. So I appreciate you watching the video. And I would even more appreciate if you guys could give it a like, comment, let me know your thoughts. If you could subscribe, that would be amazing. Share this with other people. Also, if you're ever, you know, got some crypto and you'd like to donate to help offset the amount of time and energy and money that I put into doing these kinds of things, that would be greatly appreciated. You could send Litecoin, Ripple, Bitcoin, and Ethereum to scotsybusiness.eth, as well as if you want to support me for free, feel free to download the Brave browser if you haven't already, or to just contribute tips or auto contribute when you watch my videos, also greatly appreciated. But again, if you're not trying to help me financially, just liking, subscribing, sharing, super, super helpful. And I always appreciate you guys just watching these videos. And if you did watch all the way to the end till now, make sure to comment #number1ham so I know that you did watch this entire video. And make sure to comment that in the comments below. I appreciate you. Thank you so much for watching. You're amazing. Have an amazing day. I'm Scott Cunningham, aka Scottsy Business, signing off. Cheers.